Good morning, children. Today for grade 8, we are going to see about computer science. So till last class, we have discussed about JavaScript, HTML. So in this class, we are going to continue. So from this class, we are going to learn about JavaScript variables. We are going to learn about JavaScript variables. Let us see what are the variables in JavaScript. So variables are the names assigned to the memory location that can be used for storing data. Yes, why we use variable? To store the data, we will use variables. So its value can change during the execution of a script. Yes, when we are executing a program, the value will change. A variable can have a short name like X or a more description name like F and F name. So these variables by default hold only one value at a time. If you try to assign another value, then the previous one is overwritten. Yes, sometimes we can able to see during the execution of the program the value will get changes. So it will be assigned to the variable. So this is called variable. For example, A equal to 2 and B equal to 3. If we want to store the value in C, so A plus B equal to C. So what is the A value? 2 plus 3 equal to 5. So C will assign the value 5. So following rules are to be followed when we are assigning name to the variable. We have to follow some rules when we are assigning the name to the variable. Let us see what they are. Variable name are case sensitive. What is meaning of case sensitive? So if we are giving capital letter, it won't accept. Only we have to give it a small letter. So Y and Y are two different variables. So it can contain letter A to Z and A to Z, digit 0 to 9 and underscore only. No other special variable will be, special characters will be used. So it must start with a letter or an underscore character. So it should not start with numbers, it should start only with the characters. What is meaning of characters? It is nothing but letters. So it cannot contain empty space. Yes or no? Yes, each and every variable should be assigned. So it cannot contain empty space. It cannot have more than 255 characters. So if we are giving the variable name, it should not exceed more than 255 characters. So it cannot be one of the language's reserved words. So keywords such as bar, alert, etc. Int, character, var. So the variable name should not be language reserved words. So keywords are reserved words for language. That name should not be used as variable name. So declare a variable in JavaScript. Let us see how to declare the variable in JavaScript. So we can declare a variable in JavaScript by using var. So how we can declare var along with the variable name? So each and every language have different variables. So variable declaration. So in JavaScript, we will use var with variable name. Variable name may be letters or numbers, or we can use underscore, but it should not start with numbers. It can start with letters. So they have given variables n1, fname and age are declared below. How to declare this? Variable name should start with var n1, comma result, var fname, var age. So this is the way to declare the variable name in JavaScript. So here we can able to see, let us write a small program to see the usage of variables. So HTML, I have already discussed how to write the HTML tag. Open tag, HTML, close. So HTML, body, script language. What script language we are using? JavaScript. Then var, fname. How we can declare the variable? Using the var. Var, fname equal to Daniel. Document dot write hello calculations. So using variables or constant. What are called as arithmetic operators? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and modulus. For addition, 2 plus 4 result is 6. Subtraction, 6 minus 2, 4. Multiplication, 5 3 is 15. Division, 15 by 3, 5. Modulus, 10. Modulus of 3 is 1. So, let us see an example for arithmetic operators. HTML code using arithmetic operators. So, first we have to declare the tag HTML. Next, body. Script language is JavaScript. So, variable A equal to 2. What is the variable name here? A. So, variable A equal to 2. Variable B equal to 10. What has to be written in the document? Document.write. The addition of two numbers is equal to. So, we have to add these two numbers. So, variable result. So, I have declared the variable A and B. Where I have to store the result? In the variable result. So, variable result equal to A plus B. So, 2 plus 10 equal to 12. So, document.write result. I have to display the result. Document.write break the multiplication of the two numbers. Next, we are moving to the multiplication. So, what is the multiplication? It will multiply the two values. So, I have to store the result A star B. So, first addition we will get answer as 12. Then, during multiplication we will get answer as 20. Because 10 2 is 20. 10 plus 2 is 12. So, next we are going to comparison operators. What are comparison operators? Equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, greater than, equal to and less than. Equal. We are going to compare any two things. Comparison operators are used to test if the two variables relate to each other or not. Why is equal to? So if we are using equal to, this side and that side should be same. So is equal to 10, is this equal to true? 20, is it true? No, because 10 is not equal to 20. So false. Not equal to 10 is not equal to 20. Yes, yes, true. Greater than 10, greater than 20, false. Less than 10, less than 20, true. Greater than equal to 10, greater than or equal to 20, no, it is less than 10, less than or equal to 20, yes, true. This is the use of comparison operators. Next, we are going to logical operators. So, logical operators are used to perform logical operations. What are the logical operations? And, or, and, not. And, or, and, not. So, first we are using and, x equal to 2, y equal to 3. So x less than 10 and y greater than 1. Yes, yes. Because x value is 2, it is less than 10. Y value is 3, it is greater than 1. So it is true. Next one, or. X equal to 12, y equal to 3. X is equal to 5, or y equal to 5, it is false. So because x is not equal to 5, or y is not equal to 3. If any one condition is true, it returns true. But here both the conditions are false because x value is not 5 or y value is not 5. So it returns false. Next, not. So y equal to 3. Not x is equal to y. It returns true. Yes, because we don't know the value of x. So it returns true. Next, we are moving to string operator. String is nothing but it is used to combine two words or two letters. So it is called string operator. So define the tag HTML, read the body, scripting language, JavaScript, variable. We are declaring two variables, string1 and string2, because we are going to compare two strings. So str1 and str2. So string1 is hello, string2 is friends. Document.write string1 plus string2 plus break. So we have to combine hello friends 2. So document.write string plus double quotes plus string 2. So let us see what is the output for this. So the HTML code using window adapt method. HTML head title using window adapt. You can give any title, adapt message, window adapt, anything. So close title, close head, body. Adapt window demo. Heading is adapt window demo. Script JavaScript. Adapt hi. JavaScript is very interesting. JavaScript is very interesting. So close body, close HTML. So you can able to see an alert message. Yes, we can able to see an alert message. So message from web page, what it is? Hi, JavaScript is very interesting. So here we can able to click only OK button. Next we are moving to window.confirm method. So in the dialog box appears. So here we can able to have two buttons. What are they? OK and cancel buttons. So if we want to save, if we want to make modification, we can click OK button. If we don't want to perform that action, we can click on the cancel button. It is confirmation whether yes or no, it is OK or cancel. So let us see example for this. So the syntax for the confirm box is window.confirm message or confirm of message. So here we are going to use window.confirm. HTML, body, script language is JavaScript. So variable reply equal to confirm. You must always follow the traffic rules, yes or no. So you have to say whether you are following yes or no. So if you are following, you click the OK button. If you are not following, you can click the cancel button. This is about the confirm message. So next we are moving to window.prompt method. So the prompt dialog box is also a method of the window object. Yes or no, have you heard about the prompt? Let us see. So syntax for the prompt is windows.prompt message comma default value or prompt message comma default value. Message means this can be any text to be displayed in the prompt window. Default value means this can be any default value given in an input box. Okay, let us see. So here we are writing the program. HTML, body, script language is JavaScript, variable name 1. Name 1 equal to entry of friend's name. So in this dialog box we are going to enter the friend's name. Document.write, font color blue. So what is the font color of this box? Blue. Then size is 6. Hello plus name 1. What is the name 1? So we have to enter the friend's name. Break, which book do you read today? So which book do you read today? So the prompt box is like this. If you are entering the data, you can get the output like this. So this is the prompt window and we can able to get the output like this. is correct. So the total value is 13.